What day is it today?
I don't know, Monday?
October 31st.
Ah.
Hi!
Hi!
My name's Matilda, aka Nerdygirl.
And I'm Vanya, aka Quantum.
And this is the Halloween special of Nerdygirl
and Quantum.
Yay! this is gonna have finally thrown together. We're in my room. It's a huge mess in here. But at least the camera shot looks good. The sound's terrible, but we're using a webcam. We're just gonna have a blast and talk about Halloween.
I like Halloween.
Me too. Christmas is my favorite holiday, but Halloween is second favorite.
I like them both. They're both awesome.
Yeah, but Christmas is like the entire month. That's lovely.
That's true.
It's like from December 1st. Or here in Sweden, it's first Advent, which can be the last Sunday of November too, all the way to December 26th.
Yeah.
That's, and then everything drops dead.
Yeah.
Well, the sales too, but they have nothing to do with Christmas. But enough about Christmas, we're here to talk about the holiday of jack-o'-lanterns. Halloween. This is the only jack-o'-lantern we found. I had it in a closet for some reason. But, you know. You don't say. Shut up. I'm going to put my phone on silent. Okay. Yeah. Maybe not. We'll see. And by the way, I want to excuse my hair to begin with. It's really washed out. I have roots now. I'm so unused to having roots. Like, look at this. It doesn't look too awful right now, but...
And I've cut my hair since last time.
Yeah, but last time was like a year ago.
Yeah, so maybe not that weird. I like hair on short hair.
Yeah. I think what I have, like, right now is about the perfect for me, like, shoulder length. No more, no less, but enough about our hair. We're here to talk about Halloween, and we're gonna take up three subjects. We're gonna take up candy.
Movies
and music,
and as a bonus, why Halloween isn't as fun in Sweden?
Yeah, well, why America and most other countries, like most countries apart from Sweden, I don't know all the like only know about Halloween from the Americans, but how they have a much greater appreciation for Halloween than Sweden does. But that doesn't mean Sweden has no. I'm gonna keep going on with my hair for like forever because my hair is stupid. But we're gonna start by talking about the top 5 candies. Woo! So the top 5 candies, according to us, are number 1.
Snickers.
It's an American candy bar that most people are familiar with that tastes awesome.
Yeah, I really like it. It's classic.
And the commercial is great. You're not you when you're hungry. And one of them even includes Rowan Atkinson, aka Mr. Bean, as a ninja.
No.
And the combination of chocolate and peanuts is endless to any candy. Any candy with chocolates and peanuts. I'm sold. Peanut butter makes it even better.
Yeah.
I'm like Link. I'm a big peanut butter lover. Okay. The next one is a kind of a boring one, but at the same time not. It's lollipops or suckers or like those types of hard candy. Once again, they're classic. I'm so hungry. But they're classic.
And they come in a lot of shapes, sizes,
colors, flavors.
Everything.
You can fit them for any occasion.
Yeah.
They can be teeny tiny and they can be giant. They can be shaped like him or they can be shaped like her.
Me.
Well, yeah. What we're saying here is that lollipops are very customizable. That was a fancy word.
It was.
But they are. You can shape them like skulls, Jack Skellington, jack-o'-lanterns, vampires, anything. Vanya. And yeah, they're easy. They can be both cute and scary depending on the occasion. Like, You may not want to give a bloody looking brain lollipop to a 5-year-old child, but to someone who's really into The Walking Dead, sure, why not? Okay, we're gonna save that for last because it doesn't need much of an explanation.
That's true.
Okay, the next is Skittles.
Skittles. I'm
actually not too fond of Skittles, but that's because I'm not too fond of candy in general. I'm more of a desserts person, honestly. I'm more like cakes and... No, not cake. I don't like cake either. I'm more like cookies. Cookies! I mean, hey, my hair's blue. I'm the Cookie Monster. But, yeah.
Well, Skittles, they're tasty. And,
she has a personal connection to Skittles.
Yeah, because first time I ate them, I was in England. So, I, like, connect Skittles with England.
And they are, well, talking about variety, they do have a bunch of different flavors, but not all of them are that big in difference. I mean, there's not too much of a difference between lemon and orange, or, you know,
yeah.
Yeah! And then we have gummy candy, which I don't like at all.
I like them. I really like them.
I don't know why I don't like gummy candy. I think it's because the fake sweetness. It's like artificial, and it's like chewing on a tire. I mean, some gummy candy I adore, like some types of gummy, but some are just like, yeah, I'm chewing on a piece of rubber that tastes like artificial applesauce.
I do usually chew on artificial applesauce.
But yeah, and the thing with gummy is that they're also so customizable. Here in Sweden, we can find both gummy teeth and gummy brains. Like this size, but you know. And on places like Back 19, you can buy a full size gummy skull or gummy brain.
I didn't know that.
Now you do. So yeah. So they're easy to make scary, but you can still make them cute scary, just like the lollipops. So you mean, and you know, gummy worms, they look kind of disgusting if you use them in the correct way, but still, they're kind of cute.
Yeah.
And then, the number one best candy ever! Chocolate. Yes, we did talk about things that do include chocolate, like Skittles. No, Skittles. Snickers! There's no chocolate in Skittles. But chocolate is so multi-sided and even more customizable than any of these other candies. I love chocolate. I'm a chocoholic, and to be honest, I do prefer a little bit darker chocolate compared to things like milk chocolate. And I hate white chocolate.
I love chocolate.
Yeah, I don't know why, but I don't hate white chocolate. I just don't like it.
All kind of chocolate.
Yeah, I yeah. Yeah, it's white chocolate. So that's it for the candy section of this episode. Yay! Applause for us.
Okay, let's move on.
I'm okay. I swallowed my own saliva. Alright, but another thing with Halloween is that you get an opportunity to watch horror movies without anyone judging you.
Yay!
I personally still don't watch horror movies. I'm into like horror stories. I love horror stories, but I hate horror movies.
I like horror. Movies and stories.
You like horror.
I like horror. No, but, horror movies and stories.
We're
like
gonna take the four horror movies and then two movies that are not so horror-ish for people like me to watch. So we're gonna start off with the classic, one of the first horror movies ever, Psycho. Most people are familiar with the scene from Psycho with this soundtrack. And a woman being killed in the shower.
Yeah.
Thanks for that, Alfred Hitchcock. Which was the director of that movie, I think. Don't quote me on that! We didn't do any research.
Nope.
Relevant joke. But yeah, then I'm gonna hand this over to you, because she knows what she's talking about.
Okay, I've seen quite a lot of horror movies, and I like very few horror movies, because I think most of them are just like, they're made for scaring you. There's no story in them. They're just like scary scenes. Anyways,
I'm gonna be on my phone real quick because I'm gonna prepare for the next part of the Halloween special.
Okay, I'm gonna start with The Shining, which is well, the book's written by Stephen King, and it's about a family on three. It was a long time ago since I saw this, so a family on three taking care of a hotel during winter, and things get scary. Yeah, I like the book better, but I like all kind of books.
Bookworm 101 with Vanya.
Yay. Okay, and then there's The Conjuring. It's two movies, and in both of them you follow, oh god, I've forgotten the name of them.
You follow a character?
No, two. A pair, a married couple, I think. And these ones are based on true stories. And you follow a married couple in both of them, and they hunt demons or ghosts and that kind of shit.
I would never watch that movie.
Those are awesome. I love them. One of my favorite, two of my favorite movies. There are two, The Conjurings. Okay. And then there's,
whatever you call them. I know my handwriting is terrible.
I can read it.
Sinister.
Sinister. Yeah.
They're, I think.
Yeah, I think.
I can't even read my own handwriting.
That's embarrassing.
That's how terrible it is.
Yeah. No. Sinister. And oh my god, this one is very hard to explain. There are two Sinister movies. One and two, obviously. And
no, three and four.
Well, it's about, in the first movie there's a author, and he's, yeah.
He's, love the look I gave you there.
He's he and his family moves to a house where there have been a weird murder, and he's writing like books about murders.
Is it like a haunted house or something?
Quite, not really. It's not the house that is haunted, not really. But it's hard to explain, and as in all horror movies, things get weird.
Like in life.
Yeah, but it's very exciting, very scary. And in the other one, you follow a deputy. And I don't think he has a name. Yeah. And it's oh my god. They're awesome, and I love the music in them.
So watch those them. Are movies you can watch. The Shining, The Conjuring, Psycho, and Sinister. But if you're like me, that you don't like to watch, like on movies, you don't like to watch people getting scared and gore. I love like gore and stuff in cartoons and in stories, but on real life action movies, I can't watch it. So there are two movies that I would like to suggest to people like you. The number one is a movie which soundtrack, whether you've watched it or not, you know. Ghostbusters. Ghostbusters is a 1980s movie, so the quality, both of these are 80s movies, by the way. And the quality is poop, but they're funny. And the thing with the quality is it adds to the comedic effect of these movies. So Ghostbusters are about, there are three Ghostbusters, but two like old ones, and then like a couple of years ago they came out with a female version that I haven't seen because I'm too scared like to see what the hell's going on here. It's not like I'm like, oh my god, monsters. It's more like, oh please don't that. Okay, but yeah, so it's basically about this doctor, which names I have forgot. I'm terrible with names, just so you know. Mm-hmm. And he works at a university, but he gets kicked out because his research isn't doing any progress. But instead he opens a company with two of his colleagues, and they are called the Ghostbusters. and they fight supernatural creatures all over a small city. And in the first movie, a giant marshmallow monster appears, and the whole city ends up getting covered in melted marshmallow. I don't call that Ghostbusters, I call that Paradise. other than Ghostbusters, which are very family friendly, very funny, and in the second movie, there's also a monster that joins the crew called Slimer, and he is awfully looking. But I hate slime, like slimy things, so meh. But yeah, the next one is Beetlejuice, which is not scary, it's just kind of creepy. And Beetlejuice is basically a couple who buys a house, like in the countryside, a beautiful little village, but something happens and they end up driving off a bridge and die. Then they get stuck in the house they're living in and are forced to haunt it. They're kind of in this undead world, and they get a handbook called The Manual for Newly Diseased. So you get to follow this couple around in the world of dead people. And then they see a commercial about a guy named Beetlejuice, and you just have to call his name 3 times for him to appear, but he is a real trickster and just screws things up, and yeah.
We were talking about dead people, and I just remember a movie I've seen. It's called The Sixth Sense.
Sixth on its own is a difficult word to say, and then probably sense.
And it's about a little boy who can see dead people.
Then there's also this, it's Silence of the Lambs. I haven't heard too much about it, but it's about a serial killer called Hannibal Lecter, which I do know a little bit about the character itself, so I think that could be a really cool movie.
Yeah.
If you're into that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's enough. And yes, I'm wearing shorts. My foot's falling asleep, so I'm trying to correct my feet. But yeah, that's enough about movies! Way! More applause! And as promised, we're gonna talk about music. I have prepared a list with the top 5, or according to us, top 5 Halloween songs, or they're not directly linked to Halloween, but they kind of fit. Okay, so we are gonna go from the bottom to the top.
Sounds good, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna plug into the speaker behind me. Turn it on. There we go. And the first one is the most paranoid song of all time, Somebody's Watching Me by Rockwell. So, bad turns. But yeah, Rockwell. I tend to call this the most paranoid song of all time. And the lyrics, it's about a guy who thinks that someone's always watching him. Yeah. Extreme paranoia. Let's put the camera a little closer. So yeah. So that's that. A paranoid song.
Good song.
A good paranoid song.
Yeah.
Paranoid by Black Sabbath would also work. But whatever. Then we have a song that is pretty modern, actually.
Yeah.
We don't listen to a lot of modern music. Or it was modern like 2 years ago. But to us, that's modern. And it is. If you know this soundtrack, you know what this song is about. So, I think most of you probably know this song and probably know what it's about. Five Nights at Freddy's! One of the most scary or jump scary-ish games ever. I gotta say this, at the Five Nights at Freddy's fan community, is a bit wicked at times. Not gonna say that it's not. But the game itself, especially the first game, is scary as hell. I actually have a copy on my other computer. And we played it last year.
Oh my god.
Yeah, we didn't get past the third night.
No, I was too scared.
Yeah, me too. Freaking Bonnie.
It's a fun game.
Yeah.
I recommend it.
If you like jump scares.
Yeah.
Because it's a game centered all about jump scares. But
yeah.
Not about video games.
It's fun, but scary.
And the storyline and the whole plot has gotten me really interested. Interested. Like the plot. It's like a whole story about how the robots end up killing you.
Yeah.
Then, a soundtrack from another movie that you may or may not have watched, or may or may not would like to watch, or whatever. And... And first of all, it sounds a little creepy. I love how you're singing here, like... I'm like dead on the inside. This is Halloween. Yeah, most people probably know it from like Nightmare Before Christmas, I think. I said, don't quote me on that. I think it's Nightmare Before Christmas. I haven't seen that movie.
Me neither.
But I've heard it's a good movie, and I think it's the origin of Jack Skellington. The character. Not like a random person called Jack Skellington, but yeah. So, we're coming up to the second best Halloween song ever. It is a bit paranoid, this too, but... rebellion, and I really like that about him. Secondly, his last name's Cooper. Think of another character that I may like whose last name is Cooper. She knows what I'm talking about.
I know what you're talking about.
Sheldon Cooper!
Yeah,
from the Big Bang Theory. Just saying this. That's the wall in my room.
Yeah, it is.
Not sure I can say that, but... So yeah, Man Behind the Mask, and it's also from a movie. And it's about a man who had a hockey mask on, who went around killing people.
Okay.
And then, for the
it's
best...
the first one.
The best Halloween song ever!
Here we go.
Music video, it has that too. It's seriously one of the most known authors or like voices within horror movies is the one that talks like darkness and creepy ghouls from every something. I don't know my facts, all right?
Okay.
But yeah, This is seriously one of the best Halloween songs and one of the best music videos ever.
Yeah.
If there are more songs I could suggest for you, it would be Cannibal by Kesha. It would be Feed My Frankenstein with Alice Cooper. She-Wolf with Shakira. What is there more? Ghost by Ella Anderson. Monster by Skillet. Imagine Dragons or Rihanna.
Yeah. I don't have very many songs to suggest because I listen most to this guy.
Yeah, I listen to everything and anything.
Yeah.
As long as it's catchy. But well, currently I've been a bit into like Daft Punk. Human After All by Daft Punk! That's actually a really good song.
Well, I suggest all of this kind of song, Bruce Springsteen. Because
all year round, though.
Because I love him. He's awesome.
So yeah, that's that. So for the following like 4 minutes or so, we are going to talk about why Halloween may or may not suck in Sweden.
Yeah.
One of the reasons that it doesn't is quite so big in Sweden is because this is as far as people go with Halloween decorating.
Yeah.
Really crappy jack-o'-lanterns. Like, I bought this at Ica, which is like the Swedish version of Walmart, last year. And it's just by two AA batteries and it's just boom.
There we are.
There we are. Halloween!
In Sweden.
Yeah. And then, on November 1st, nothing. Nothing.
Well, I think most people really want to celebrate Halloween.
But since most traditional people, and by that I'm sad to say it's often the older generation, like those who are 40 and above, those who were born in the 70s and before, meaning our parents.
Yeah.
But my parents aren't like that, but most within that time period, like if they're like in their late 40s, 50s now, they don't like Halloween. They think it's stupid and that it's just an imported holiday from America. Who the hell cares?
It's interesting.
Yeah, one of the most Swedish things ever is American. Donald Duck on Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
I said it. We watch old Disney cartoons every Christmas Eve at 3 p.m.
Uh-huh.
Every year. Everyone in Sweden does. And no one complains about that being American.
Nope.
Just an old tradition that's older than Donald Duck himself. I'm not trying to fight, like, I like watching Donald Duck at Christmas Eve, and I like Halloween. I can't be like both. It's not like Donald Duck and no Halloween, or Halloween, no Donald Duck. Both. But one good thing about Sweden is that we have tons of candy.
Yeah.
There's candy.
I like candy.
Yeah. And in these stores, you can, like, just take a paper bag, fill it with candy, and pay for how much. Bought, and that's awesome.
Yeah.
And tasty. I'm actually not that much for candy, honestly.
I like candy.
Yeah, I like candy, but I prefer like cookies. I said it, cookies.
All kinds of sweets, I can eat them.
Yeah, but I don't like candy too much. Chocolate is my life. Cookies is my life. But I hate stuff like licorice, salt candies, sour candies. My bangs are covering my left eye. I hate that too. Okay, but yeah. We want to thank you for watching our Nerdygirl&Quantum Halloween special. And if you would like us to do one of these for Christmas, please tell us in the comment box below. We'd love to make it for you.
Yep.
So yeah. Thanks for watching. I'm Nerdygirl.
And I'm Quantum.
And we're signing off. Bye!